to the town of Auffrey, who rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24, and the notches on his pistol numbered 1 in 19 more. 1 in 19 more. Now the stranger started talking, made it plain to folks around. Was an Arizona ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead. And he said it didn't matter, he was after Texas Red. After Texas Red. Wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry, men that tried before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. The morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 11:20 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today. Texas Red had not cleared leather for a bullet fairly ripped. And the ranger's aim was deadly with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Big iron, big iron. When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. I was hanging around town, just spending my time. Out of a job, not earning a dime. A feller steps up and he said, I suppose you're a bronc fighter from the looks of your clothes. You figures me right, I'm a good one I claim. Do you happen to have any bad ones to tame? Said he's got one, a bad one to buck. For throwing good riders, he's had lots of luck. I gets all head up, and I ask what he pays to ride this old nag for a couple of days. He offered me 10, and I said, I'm your man. A bronc never lived that I couldn't fan. He said, get your saddle, I'll give you a chance. In his buckboard we hops and he drives to the ranch. I stayed until morning and right after chuck, I stepped out to see if this outlaw can buck. down in the horse corral, standing alone, is an old caballo, a strawberry roan. His legs are all spavined, he's got pigeon toes, little pig eyes and a big Roman nose, little pin ears that touch at the tip. A big 44 brand was on his left hip. You neck and all with a long lower jaw, I could see with one eye he's a regular outlaw. I gets the blinds on him and it sure is a fright. Next comes my saddle and I screws it down tight. Then I steps on him and I raises the blind. Get out the way, boys, he's gonna unwind. He sure is a frog walker, he heaves a big sigh. He only likes wings for to be on the fly. He turns his old belly right up to the sun. He sure is a sunfish and son of a gun. He's about the worst bucker I've seen on the range. He'll turn on a nickel and give you some change. He hits on all fours and goes up on high. Leaves me a spinning up there in the sky. I turns over twice and I comes back to earth. A light's in a cussin' the day of his birth. I know there are ponies that I cannot ride. There's some of them left, they haven't all died. I'll bet all my money the man he liked.